AT, and I'm repping North Carolina Central. We bring you greetings on behalf of our sponsors and on behalf of the North Carolina Central University on the Campus All-Star Challenge. And since we're talking about HBCUs, how many of North Carolina's 12 HBCUs can you name? Please type your ideas.
Off the top of my head, I don't know how many come. I think I could do like five. This is pretty hard. This might be pretty easy for you though.
Yeah, it's kind of what we do.
This is his forte.
Yeah, HCASC.com. Make sure you check us out next week at our national qualifying tournaments. Players, type your ideas.
You guys are doing something tonight or tomorrow?
Tomorrow night, we will host the Aggies in our stream on YouTube at HCASC at NCCU. So come check us out. We love to see you all, see us and what we do and how intelligent our HBCU students are. All right, no need to answer this time.
All right, and I want to give a special shout out tonight to Your Pie Pizza with their signature pizzas and pasta, salads, paninis, and more. They've got three locations in the Triangle, Carytown Boulevard in Cary, and Briar Creek in Capitol Boulevard. And Raleigh, right where I reside, I've tasted the pizza today, and it is beautiful. So come on down.
I am a fan. Once again, shout out to the Briar Creek location. We go there about once every 2 weeks. My son loves it also.
Yes, make sure you check out and pick up menus more online at yourpie.com. And I do not want to forget one thing about these beautiful candles. I'm not going to compete for the sake of the competition. So the winner of today's event can party as long as the candle keeps burning. We got a fantastic grand prize from Bright Black Candles. They are locally Black owned candle makers, all about history. Last year, they had beautiful Ida B. Wells candles to celebrate 100 years of some women's suffrage. This year is all about the diaspora. They're celebrating some of the epicenters of Black culture, from Kingston to Addis Ababa to Durham. You can see more of the diaspora collection at brightblackcandles.com.
Here we go. The Black National Anthem. I hope that you all were able to sing it a little bit earlier. Written by James Weldon Johnson. It's pretty awesome.
Yes, just to get us started, if you know the words, please, please, please sing along now. I will mute myself so that you guys do not hear the vibes that I'm bringing to the show.
Pre-pandemic, I hosted karaoke, but I will not butcher you all's ears with my rendition of the Black National Anthem. But everybody else can be spirited and sing along with your teams out there. Such beautiful words. Such beautiful words being expressed on screen, and I hope that you feel this anthem as much as we do. And you know, one of the best parts of going to HBCU is hearing the Black National Anthem played before our football games alongside the national anthem. I remember I brought some friends who weren't used to that, and it was a eye-opening experience for them. So hey, HBCUs, we've got our own culture, we do our own thing, and now we are exporting that culture to everybody, and we want you to join in and enjoy it along with us.
Yes, yes. I remember my first coronation when I got to hear all of it. You know, they kind of indoctrinated into you mm-hmm. when you're younger in church. And then it's like, when do we sing this? At A&T, we sang it before everything. It seems like some people would just burst out in the cafeteria with, did you know the verse? I mean, I think it's a... If I feel it a little bit more after my experience at A&T, so I appreciate the culture, the people, and everyone there for that. And if you have had an experience, I encourage you to share it with us at WUNC, or just share it with your friend right now as you are singing this, because we got all the verses, and I've never, ever, ever went through all of them with everyone. So I'm glad y'all are not experiencing that live.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's telling a story and makes you proud to be Black and proud to be an American and proud of our culture and our history and what we brought to this American story.
That's a fact. Like, reading the words right now, it's heavy, but I hope that you guys feel invigorated because you're about to get into it.
All right, let's lay down some rules for tonight. Groups are allowed. Your group will play from a single device, though. But if you win, you're legally obliged to divide the prizes equally. So I don't know how y'all feel about dividing a candle in half, but hey, it's okay. Don't cheat. We can't enforce that, but it makes the whole night a lot less fun for everybody. If you don't know the answer, take it as an opportunity to learn, and we will learn a lot tonight. Each question has a time limit. So if you don't have the answer before that time is up, you're not getting any points.
And don't you get more points if you answer quicker?
Yes, that is how Cahoots works. So, hey, we encourage you all to answer as quickly as possible.
All right, all right. Any HBCU students or alums in the audience, get in the comments so we know where you come from. Who do you, where do you hail from? And we'll let the scores speak for themselves.
All right. I got my money on anybody playing from NCCU or Shaw or St. Aug or A&T or Fayetteville State.
North Carolina, take your shirt off.
Twist there you go.
Head.
Livingstone, John C. Smith, Bennett College, all of them. We're going to do what we do today. First round is about Black love, and we're starting off a little slow. We'll just do three questions. If you're having any questions, any problems during these first three, please comment on YouTube or Facebook, and we'll try to help you. And let's go. Raised in High Point, he married jazz harpist Alice Need McLeod. Who is the saxophonist behind A Love Supreme, is it? Ornette Coleman, Coleman Hawkins, Nat King Cole, or John Coltrane?
This is tough, but not for me. That's why I'm not competing. I'm playing with
you. Oh, okay. You all
you guys
over
it got it. You know what I'm saying? This is easy. Like 5 seconds, I got it. I know some of you out there are on fire.
Already.
Good question.
All right, 9 of you got it correct, and that answer was John Coltrane. Congratulations to those teams or individuals playing. Glad Cheetah in the lead with 663 points. Royal Sphinx following right behind with 656 points, followed by some other players and teams. And hey, everybody, we're just getting started, so you got plenty of time to catch up. On to the next question, please. She produced Bridgerton. Who is this TV executive creator of Grey's Anatomy? Is it Shonda Rhimes, Kerry Washington, Mabel Simmons, or Kenya Barris? Well, I know one of those you can eliminate.
I know one. Especially if you are a fan of plays, of interest in plays.
Yes. And I watched the entire thing. It was all right. It's pretty good.
The entire thing?
Yes, I did. The correct answer, and 21 of you are on top of it, is Shonda Rhimes. Congratulations. In first place, we now have Glad Cheetah still holding on. Royal Sphinx in second, Agent Turtle in third, Power Bobcat fourth, Champion Stork in fifth, but they are all within striking distance as we move on to question number 3, and it is a fill in the blank. Type your answer for 2 times the points. Also from High Point, which American Idol is nicknamed Baby Patti LaBelle and wrote When I See You? Players, type your answer now.
Oh, come on, y'all. This is tough. boost to help. Because if you're from the city, from the state, it's in your heart.
And she's related to some other famous R&B singers hailing from North Carolina. They're cousins. And no, I'm not talking about her brother. He's famous. He is famous. I loved his music.
Really?
Yes. Yes. Yeah, he's a great singer.
It's a lot of rooms.
All right. The correct answers are... Yeah, let's get rid of that one. Yes, Fantasia, Barina, or Fantasia. Either one would have been accepted. Our season 3 American Idol winner and just an outstanding singer and performer. Glad Cheetah in the lead still. Royal Sphinx in second, Power Bobcat in third, Champion Stork in fourth, and Noble Wildcat in fifth. Everybody is still alive. 7 players hit a 3-streak answer. No need to answer this time. We're talking about the Black community, but hey, look at that baptism.
Is this about to go down?
And now back to the quiz. The first Greek-lettered organization to be founded at HBCU, which sorority includes Vice President Harris in its membership? Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority Incorporated, Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated. And look at that picture.
It is a nice one.
Rolling to the polls, and I love it. They are showing off in their wonderful colors.
Yes. I always wanted to be an AKA. I was just scared.
Oh, come on.
I know. It sucks. I regret to this day.
The Black Greek Letter Organization experience is second to none. The correct answer in 17 of you got it correct was Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, and they have been wilding since Vice President Harris has been elected. Glad Cheetah still in the lead by just about 110 points over Royal Sphinx, Power Bobcat, and Champion Stork breathing on their heels. And Cute Urchin is the highest climber. Cute Urchin, that is an interesting, I hope you're using urchin interchangeably with child. Anyway, okay, we can move to the next question.
That was hilarious. I think we should do an inner bit.
The African-American resort Chuan Beach was founded in 1926. It became part of this famed Southern performance circuit. The Cornbread Circuit, the Soul Train Circuit, the Soul Food Circuit, the Chitlin Circuit. Hey, those pictures may mean something. You never know.
Make sure you answer quickly because the time is off because of the YouTube lag. So make sure you are answering as fast as possible so you can get that answer in.
I.e. follow your phone, not the stream. The phone is real time. The correct answer is the Chitlin Circuit, and 12 of you got that correct. Eli Reed started Chuan Beach in Hertford County along the Chuan River. It drew top entertainers like Duke Ellington, Cab Calloway, and Lena Horne. Thanks to Albemarle Regional Library for this question. We learned a whole lot about Black history in Eastern North Carolina thanks to their questions. Glad Cheetah trying to extend their lead. 4-1-4-2. Royal Sphinx still in within striking distance, and the other teams haven't moved. We'll see what happens. The Winston-Salem chapter ran a free ambulance. What revolutionary org was founded by Huey Newton? Southern Christian Leadership Conference, Nation of Islam, the Black Panther Party, COINTELPRO. Well, I know at least one of those you can get rid of.
If you know anything.
Yeah.
Just roll it back. Also, I hope you guys have seen the most recent movie, Shameless Plug. You should watch Judas and the Black Messiah. It's real good.
I'm behind. I will catch up. I promise.
It's necessary.
I heard it was wonderful. Yeah. I heard it was wonderful. All right. With 14 people answering correctly, the Black Panther Party is correct. Good job, people. Glad Cheetah still in the lead and by about 140 points. Royal Sphinx in second. The rest of you still have time to catch up. 7 players hit an answer streak of 6. Maybe these are too easy, but I think we're going to slow them down right now, Kamaya. The next question. Well, let's take a break. No need to answer. Video question. Pay attention.
Call the greatest school under the sun.
Situated on 7th Street, Williston was founded by abolitionists in 1866 after the Union had seized Wilmington and as the city's Black community began to prosper. Again, Willie Earl Vereen.
It meant a lot to me and it meant a lot to my family. It meant a lot to every Black person that went to school in Wilmington, North Carolina. Everybody wanted to graduate from Williston Senior High School. because it was an industrial high school. It gave us a sense of pride and dignity and self-respect.
And that was a video from the WUNC Politics Podcast with Jeff Tiberi, Rusty Jacobs, and a whole lot of other folks from WUNC who chime in every now and then.
And here's your question. Black students boycotted Wilmington school integration and advocated for more equitable city spending in what year? 1954, 1961, 1971, 1968. Remember, the faster you answer, the more points you can get.
And there is a delay. Focus on your phone. Hopefully you're not on the computer because that is delayed too. But it's all good because we're going to get them in here. 41 seconds left. Y'all can do it. I was really betting on Agent Turtle because I thought that was such a clever name. It's like healthy but slow, and then you win the race. And now that's where my heart was.
Well, Kamai, I understand that you were a Black History champion when you were at A&T.
Oh, no, no. Please don't give me that credit. I have with the A&T folks. I was a Black History champ when I was in eighth grade in Atlanta, Georgia with Price Middle School.
It counts. We'll take it.
It does. It's like we went in there, we thought about it, and we got it done.
All right. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. That question is now complete. The correct answer is 1971, and 9 people got that correct. Those boycotts were targeted by white supremacist terrorism. Black students were shot at while meeting in a church, and the young people armed themselves in defense. Those events escalated to the firebombing of Mike's Grocery and the wrongful conviction of 9 Black men and 1 white woman for the crime. FBI and state police were actively surveilling Ben Chavis through COINTELPRO. Chavis had recently led an 18-month boycott in his hometown of Oxford. Check out more about that story on the WUNC Politics Podcast. Raw Spink still in the lead. Champion Stork a little bit behind Smart Rabbit, Glad Cheetah, and Power Bobcat. These names are totally awesome. Tough round, though. Four players lost their answer streak. I told you this one was going to be a good one. Next question. Drummer Max Roach was born near Elizabeth City, just south of which refuge for enslaved people? Gullah Geechee Corridor, Hatteras Island, Princeville, the Great Dismal Swamp.
Quick, this one is quick. No time.
No time.
Please. Yeah. Maybe if you zoom in, maybe not. It could be.
All right. Two of you got it correct this time. The Great Dismal Swamp is what we were looking for. George Washington's failed attempt to drain the swamp for farmland, but a lot of escaped slaves went through the Great Dismal Swamp to escape slavery to try to get to the North to get freedom. Royal Sphinx is extending their lead. They've got about 659 points on the next team and a high answer streak of 8. I think they may have seen the questions before we put them up. I don't know. Well, you might just be that good, World Space. Keep on doing what you're doing, everybody. You all try to knock them off. The next question. Today, the U.S. population is about 1% Muslim. In the late 1700s, that number was likely closer to what percentage? 0.1%, 1%, 5%, 2%. The image that you see is of Omar bin Said, who is a Senegalese Muslim scholar, and he wrote his autobiography in Arabic here in North Carolina. Correct answer is 5%, and two of you got that right. Said buried in my hometown of Fayetteville, and there's a mosque named for him. Royal Sphinx in the lead, but Glad Cheetah making up. I think Cute Urchin is the highest climber up 3 places. And Royal Sphinx looked like they got stuck on that question, so streak is over. So Glad Cheetah, Champion Stork, here's your time to make your move.
This is the recovery.
Soul City was a Black utopian project of the post-civil rights movement. What North Carolina county hosts the community? Durham, Washington, Warren, Forsyth. What a cool name for a town, right? Soul City.
I wish I was there in the moment.
It puts you in a mood. It puts you in a mood. Floyd McKissick Sr. was behind that project. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Well, now you know. Alongside Eva Clayton, who is a former North Carolina representative. But the state apparently made it a little difficult for them to attract jobs. The correct answer is Warren County up to our northeast. Two of you got that correct. So let's see if we've got some changes here. We've got a new leader. Glad Cheetah with a answer streak of three has taken the lead from Royal Sphinx, and now it is a game. You all can look at each other and point eyes or whatever you do when you're mad at the other team. Next question. There are two possible answers. The Carolinas coastal region boasts a distinct Creole language. What people are divided as fresh and saltwater? Maharan, Gullah, Lumbee, Geechee.
This is an interesting one that generated some really great conversation yesterday.
It did.
I think it was great. It's a really nice deviation of how Black culture falls out. Mm-hmm. So.
All right. If you answered either Gullah or Geechee, you would be correct. Five answered Gullah and one answered Geechee. They generally distinguish themselves by the proximity to the ocean. Makes sense. Fresh versus salt water. Who knew? All right. Do we have any changes? All right, glad Cheetah has extended their lead. And Royal Sphinx still in second place. Champion Stork in third place. Noble Wildcat in fourth place. And Smart Rabbit in fifth place. Next question. This Black-led rail worker union included women and Chinese-American workers. Edie Nixon led which labor union? The Brotherhood of Sleeping Car Porters. The Brotherhood of Railroad Signalmen. The Brotherhood of Locomotive Mechanics. The Choo-Choo Change Makers.
Please use your process of elimination.
Yeah.
I'm rooting for you, Agent Turtle.
The problem here is quite a few people in today's generation don't know what a porter is. Okay, there you go. But that's correct answer. Brotherhood of Sleeping Car Porters. Ed Nixon was known for organizing a year-long Montgomery bus boycott. And he's the reason we know about Rosa Parks, but not much about Claudette Colvin. Check out Drunk History. I have a great story about her. They felt that Colvin, even though she did the same act as Parks before Parks, wasn't respectable enough to be a symbol for the movement. I don't know how they made that determination, but history is history. And there's some for you. All right. We have a new third place team. Glad Cheetah's still in the lead. Royal Sphinx in second. And Winged New. Winged New. I love that name. Winged New.
That might be the best name.
That might be the winner that I can see. Shiny Cat is the highest climber, having jumped up five spots. See, I'm tongue tied now. I'm tongue tied.
Right. We get new, did it? That's Agent Turtle. I'm sorry, you lost me. We get new.
It puts me in a mood. Gary Gnu, you know, I'm a Generation Xer. We used to watch the Great Space Coaster. It just puts me in a mood. All right, the next question. Littleton, North Carolina's Ella Baker insisted student activists stay independent. What student org formed at Shaw University in 1960? SCLC, BLOC, BYP 100, SNCC.
Also, shameless plug, Shaw is launching a new streaming service late February. So be on the lookout for it coming in the soon coming weeks.
Both NCCU and A&T refer to Shaw as Mother Shaw, as we, both of our schools are connected to, the founders of our colleges are connected to Shaw University. All right, quite a few of you thought it was SCLC, Southern Christian Leadership Conference, but this time it was SNCC, or SNCC, Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee. Ella Baker was actually old when she helped found this group. She was nearly 60 years old, but she felt that the young people at the campuses didn't need to be connected to the old church groups.
It's a bold move, I will say.
Yes, very bold. The next question is fill in the blank and is worth double the points. Bobby Jones is mayor of this first U.S. town chartered by African-Americans. What town is across the river from Tarboro? Players, type your answer.
Another interesting fact, Clayton did some work with this man or knows of the work that he has done. So that's pretty cool. But we don't have enough time to talk about it in the last 3 seconds. So I hope you got your answers in.
It's quite all right. Yeah. When they flooded a number of years ago, I went down to help with the recovery effort. All right. Princeville is what is remaining. Princeville being one of the remaining all Black towns in the entire country. Go visit it when you have a second.
Yes, and sharecroppers grew to own their own land and sell their products directly thanks to the Black-owned economy in Princeville. So shouts out to Princeville. Make sure you know.
Something to be proud of. Glad Cheetah at $6,900. Royal Sphinx at $59.99. Wing It New. I love it. $55.28. Champion Stork at $5,296. And Noble Wildcat, $5,237. Lively Ferret is the highest climber. And Kamaya,
I think you need to take a break. Everyone does. You got 2 minutes to refill your glasses, go to the bathroom, read some Toni Morrison, whatever you got to do to get ready for this next round.
All right.
I don't actually need the water because you've been going in, but I'm going to take my moment.
I literally forgot to bring some water in here with me. just my day.
That's your luck.
I have to do this again tomorrow. Once again, make sure you check us out on YouTube at HCASC at NCCU to watch the spirited scrimmage between North Carolina Central and North Carolina A&T. Also, for more information, visit hcasc.com. HCASC. I do this too much.
And while you're at it, you may want to get a first glance, if you haven't yet, at the Polly Podcast, Polly Murray Podcast that we just put out at WUNC. And I am running out of time. This is an in-between answer.
Who's your favorite contemporary Black writer or lyricist? When you get a second, type it in your answer, please.
What is yours?
See, I don't know. Black Thought.
Black Thought. I don't know why I expected. Okay.
Well, they said lyricist or writer.
They Tommy did.
I do like Tommy's Coates. I like
what he Have you seen that movie that he did about the book?
It just came up on my HBO Max, and I am so behind.
You're like significant. I didn't know. When you said behind, you're like, no, I have real things.
I have a toddler, I have a toddler and an infant. So, yeah, 10 o'clock, knocked out.
Yes. What is time? But, yeah, that I think it really brings the book to life. Between the World and Me, I think that's what it's called.
Mm-hmm. And he went to a historical Black college, Howard University.
Shout out to the Mecca. Wonderful. I don't even know what to say about it.
Yes. Another great writer to check out is Colson Whitehead. I will admit that I haven't got the chance to read Underground Railroad, but it is on my list of things to do before I get too old. But he is a prolific writer.
And Toni Adeyemi? She wrote Children of Blood and Bone. Wonderful writer. Like that book, it'll bring everything centered. I think it's a wonderful parallel of what we have to encounter today with really empathizing and understanding origins of suffrage. So check it out.
Will do. That image is from Carolyn Boston Weatherford, who's a local children's book author who gets into Black history in a beautiful way. So make sure you support Carolyn Boston Weatherford. All right, let's see what happened. We've got several listed. Ta-Nehisi Coates, Sojourner Truth, Black Thought, Maya Angelou, some misspellings here, Amanda Gorman, Roseanne Gay, Justina Ireland, Fonte, great lyricist, Nika Giovanni, Chimamanda Adichie. All right, we're back to the quiz. Born in Tryon, North Carolina, Nina Simone wrote which 1964 song condemning another state? Alabama, goddamn. Tennessee, goddamn. Mississippi, goddamn. California, goddamn. God forgive me. And you all answer.
I'm afraid of you, so it's okay. You know.
Yeah, I pray for it. When I saw this question, I said, let me not invite my church family.
May not be the best move. They may enjoy it. You know, they know. It's the next
correct the correct answer is Mississippi, goddamn. And six of you all got it correct. So people are still playing, people are still involved, and Glad Cheetah still on top. But Wing It New is in second place, and I think I actually know who Wing It New is. Royal Sphinx, Lively Ferret, and Champion
Now I gotta
Storm.
Roll it back. Now we gotta roll it back in. Wing It New, no! The
Dolly Owl is the highest climber currently. Question. Before she escaped and became a teacher, Hannah Crafts was enslaved in North Carolina. What was the title of her autobiography? The Bondswoman's Narrative, Our Nig, Dread, Incidents in the Life of a Slave Girl. Look at the penmanship. I tell you, I should have taken calligraphy in high school if they offered it in my poor high school. But they didn't.
They did what they could.
They did what they could, yes. All right. Five of you answered Incidents in the Life of a Slave Girl. That's by Harriet Jacobs. Good guess. But the correct answer is The Bondwoman's Narrative. Plaid Cheetah, still in first place. Wing It New, still in second place. Royal Sphinx, falling back to third place. And Jolly Owl is still climbing up four places. Jolly Owl, keep on playing. You might make it to the big time. Next question. Such my case, and can I then pray others may never feel tyrannic sway. Tyrannic sway. Who was the first published Black American? Gwendolyn Brooks, Phyllis Wheatley, Maya Angelou, Rita Dove, Maya Angelou. Forgive me.
There's a little... I'll save it.
You'll save it. All right, the correct answer is Phyllis Wheatley from the choices you had, with six of you answering correctly. Glad Cheetah's in the lead still. Wing It New in second, Royal Sphinx in third. Phyllis Wheatley was praised by President Washington. So, hey, just a little tidbit for you. Golden Panda is the highest climber, up four places.
Phyllis Wheatley actually is the first person that inspired me to do poetry, so that is
nice. This UNC-educated poet tried to buy his freedom with words. Who was known as the Black Bard of North Carolina? George Moses Horton, Phil Wheatley, Moses Grandy, Lunsford Lane.
What an idea, also, to buy your freedom with words. The thing that's been kept from you this entire time that you finally got a hold of illegally, and now you're like, take me as I am.
I love it. All right. George Moses Horton is the correct answer, and three of you got that correct. Good job. That picture was of Lunsford Lane, so sorry if you fell for it. Glad Cheetah in the lead and extending that lead, 1,300 points. Wing It New in second place, Royal Sphinx in third, Lively Ferret, and Golden Panda still climbing. A Hosky native, R.L. Vann, champion African-American labor rights, is editor of this nationally read Black newspaper. The Carolina Times, the Wilmington Daily Record, the Pittsburgh Courier, Q City Metro. I don't think they did you any favors in this question with the choices. So, hey, good luck.
Maybe if you have a magnifying glass on hand, this might be that moment. We should have probably put extra materials in the guidelines, because possibly.
There's always a clue in a quiz bowl question, and the clue here was nationally. Many of those other newspapers were local or North Carolina-based. Pittsburgh Courier is the correct answer, but two of you got that correct. Is that enough to change anything? Doesn't look like it, but Power Bobcat is the highest climber with three places. This lawyer, priest, and poet wrote the Dark Testament. What Durham activist coined the term? Jane Crow, Maya Angelou, Nina Freelon, Pauli Murray, Libby Cotton.
This is a beautiful question.
It really is.
The WNC lately.
An awesome, all-around awesome person. The correct answer is Pauli Murray.
A little info, Pauli Murray became the first African-American woman, U.S. Episcopal, I always suck at that.
Episcopalian, there you go.
Yeah, there you go. Episcopalian priest after the church changed its policy. And we have a new podcast, the Pauli Murray Podcast, with an event coming tomorrow at 7 p.m. So please make sure you check it out. A wonderful, awesome woman that I'm just now finding about. Shame on me. So Check it out.
Let's spend a minute with her. She's worth knowing about, but hey, no need to answer. Let's watch a video.
I must always be concerned, not theoretically, but I must be involved with and necessarily concerned with racial liberation. But I must also personally be concerned with sexual liberation, because the two, as I often say, the two meet in me.
Due to concerns about our sexuality, this Black advocacy org declined to support Murray's application to UNC, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, the Black Lawyers Association, the Negro League, the Southern Christian Leadership Conference.
I'm like the residential movie buff. Every question, I think of a great movie that just goes so perfectly along with it. I need to stop at some point.
Okay. Correct answer is the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, or the NAACP. They were very strict about its respectability politics, and Murray just did not fit in. Glad Cheetah's still in the lead. Winged New fell back a little bit. Lively Ferret finally making that jump, and Power Bobcat making a jump as well. All right, you people are switching back and forth and making this game very interesting. Later, this NAACP lawyer and future Supreme Court Justice turned to Murray's research, who represented the Browns in Brown versus Board of Education, Clarence Thomas, Frederick Douglass, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, or Thurgood Marshall. The correct answer, and many of you were on top of it, was it's Thurgood Marshall.
Yes, Murray. Murray wrote a massive tome on each state's civil rights laws. The NAACP referred to it often, and Clarence Thomas called it the Bible of the civil rights movement.
Great segment on Pauli Murray. Important. A co-founder of NOW, just all around awesome person that calls Durham home.
Yes.
All right, people, did you know about Pauli Murray before today? It's a poll. If not, I hope that we educated you a little bit about her.
Yes, and if you want to be educated just a bit more, this Sunday at 1 p.m., join WUNC on a virtual walkthrough of the city Pauli Murray called home, Durham, North Carolina.
Okay, we've got some smart people out there. Yes, I knew all about her, and a couple people said a little, and some people said they're about to learn a whole lot more. Make sure you check out next Wednesday as WUNC hosts a celebration of scholar and activist Pauli Murray featuring North Carolina poet laureate Jackie Shelton Green and a special preview of the documentary My Name is Pauli. Recently premiered at the Sundance Film Festival.
Like we said, Sunday, you will stroll through the Bull City as we listen to Pauli, a podcast from North Carolina Public Radio, all about the power of one person to change what's possible for us all. And keep checking out all of these wonderful podcasts. We got Dating While Cray, which I am on the production team of, along with Charlie Shelton and Laura Stassi. We got Embodied with Anita Rao. And we got Tested with Leonita Inge, who recently, she just texted me and was ashamed because she is an illustrious AKA. She was like, why did you feel scared? I've known you all this time. Just said, hey, I just feel like you have to be so elite. I didn't feel like I was that in sophomore year when the pledging was open. So, you know, c'est la vie. There's always alumni pledging centers. But shout out to Leonita, Tested, and all of our other podcasts.
Another proud HBCU alum from FAMU. Shout out to Leonita. She came to check out my team when we played in a tournament a few years ago. So really happy to know her. The next round about Black vanguards. And in the picture, you see a picture of Lex Gillette, who is a blind Paralympic gold medal winning athlete from Raleigh. He won for long jump and also silver for the triple jump. He's an East Carolina grad. So, hey, ECU people, y'all represent if you are listening out there in Radio Land.
Yes, we love y'all too.
The father of Chimerji, a precursor to the biotechnology field, which agronomist was known for his work with peanuts, George Washington Carver, Percy Julian, Granville T. Woods, Garrett Morgan. That looks like a painter to me.
It does. I mean, his paintings are amazing. Chimerji also, that was one for me. I had no idea. I claim to be this Black history buff. I am not.
No, you're fine. Correct answer is George Washington Carver, also known for his work with soybeans and sweet potatoes. All right, Glad Cheetah still in the lead. Lively Ferret trying to make up some, and Wing It New jumping back to third place. Power Bobcat in fourth, and Agent Turtle bringing up. Power Bobcat has the highest answer streak of 5. All right, here goes some great questions, and good luck to you all as you try to figure them out. She was on Star Trek The Next Generation. Which Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, Tony winner is seen weekdays debating on The View? Tracy Ellis Ross, Sherry Shepherd, Whoopi Goldberg, Cheryl Underwood. Kind of a giveaway here.
Yes, okay. My auntie, it's your Donna auntie? Bowie. My auntie Donna Bowie was in a movie with her. Only one scene, but she brags on it a lot. So that's amazing. I feel like we're connected somehow through some type of synergy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Whoopi Goldberg is the correct answer. 5 of you got that correct. She is a icon.
Icon.
Glad Cheetah still in the lead. Lively Ferret in second. Power Bobcat getting in third now. And Wing It New at fourth. Agent Turtle with Power Bobcat having the highest amateur streak of 6. You've got to make your move, people. We don't have many questions left. Who is the king of ragtime? Best known for Maple Leaf Rag, the first hit of that musical genre. Scott Joplin, Quincy Jones, Duke Ellington, Count Basie.
And shout out to the pictures. Thank you so much for these wonderful, beautiful, well-established illustrated pictures. I appreciate them.
Yeah, the pic is dope. That's all I'll say.
It is.
It is dope. Correct answer is Scott Joplin, and 4 of you got that correct. Any of you all who played piano growing up, you're probably familiar with hitting some ragtime tunes. They are songs that you learn really early in your piano journey. Power Bobcat making some moves. Agent Turtle as well. Lively Ferret in third place, and Glad Cheetah still on top with 10,152 points. But Funny Pony is the highest climber after that question.
Funny Pony, a new name.
Portrayed by Chadwick Boseman in 42, who was the first Black American to play Major League Baseball in the modern era? Larry Doby, Frank Robinson, Willie Mays, Jackie Robinson. Did you know that the Dodgers gained their names because they were named after people dodging above ground streetcars?
Are you serious?
Yes. The Dodgers started in New York.
So they thought it would be a great name?
Well, I imagine streetcars were a problem back then.
I guess so.
The correct answer is Jackie Robinson. 5 of you getting it right. Nobody loves Larry Doby. Larry Doby was the first person to get into the American League playing for the Cleveland Indians. Frank Robinson, of course, being the first player coach. And Willie Mays, just a Hall of Fame all-time player. But Jackie Robinson is the correct answer this time. Glad Cheetah still on top. Power Bobcat trying to make their move. 8 correct answers in a row. That's a lot of pressure on you, Glad Cheetah. I hope you can hold them off. Or we may have a new winner, a new first place team. We'll see. ABC doubted its success. Thus, which miniseries based on a Haley book was scheduled before the sweeps period in 1977? Bessie, Roots, The Wire, Queen. It should be pretty easy.
Should.
O.J. Simpson and LeVar Burton. LeVar Burton is an icon as well. Yes. I wish they would allow him to host Jeopardy.
Oh, that makes so much sense. I was always thinking, who would replace Alex?
An entire generation grew up on Reading Rainbow.
That's me.
There you go. Roots is the correct answer, and 8 of you got that right. Some of you went for The Wire, and one person went for Queen. Queen was also by Alex Haley. It was about his mother's side of the family. Glad Cheetah still in the lead. Lively Ferret trying to make a move. Power Bobcat, 2 points separating second and third place. Agent Turtle there, and Groovy Tiger. Is that new? Groovy Tiger's new?
That is
Groovy,
a new name.
All right. You all have some dope name. Power Bobcat, 9 questions in a row. Let's see if we can make it 10.
I believe in y'all. I really hope.
A multi-choice Multiple choice question, a UNC student took a swing at this anti-war activist and champ boxer who responded, "You ain't no Joe Frazier." Muhammad Ali, Cassius Clay, Sugar Ray, Ezra Charles. Make sure that you choose two answers.
And if you seen One Night in Miami, hello, that's a shameless plug. There you go.
I got a better one, the Louisville Lip.
There we go.
There you go. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. We're looking, of course, for Muhammad Ali and his previous name, Cassius Clay, before he converted to the Nation of Islam. Two of you got it right, and one of you got it on the other one. Good job.
You're like built for this, huh? The DJ, it jumps out. You're so smooth with it. I really love it.
DJ, and remember, I'm a quiz bowl person.
You are, but it's like the DJ, the float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. We're looking for Muhammad Ali.
Yeah, that's what I did.
That's the flavor.
Ruben Tiger has the highest answer streak of three. Looks like Power Bobcat got stuck on that one. I guess they did not answer both questions. Sorry. Pay attention. This is a game. A court ordered Hasbro to pay Lonnie Johnson $73 million in royalties in 2013. What enhanced water gun toy did he patent? Intertech, Water Warriors, Aqua Blasters, Super Soap. Just a reminder that the top three teams or players will receive a prize. Lonnie Johnson, a Tuskegee graduate, worked for NASA. I think he was at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory when he developed the Super Soaker, and Hasbro bought it after he had sold it to the original company, Laramie, and they owed him a lot of money. There are over 1 billion sold Super Soakers. It is one of the most popular toys of all time and is in the Toy Hall of Fame.
And I have three currently.
I can't wait. I got to get another one. All right. Glad Cheetah, Lively Ferret trying to make a move. We got some players and teams in five digits now. There you go. Yeah. Groovy Tiger with a streak of four correct answers in a row. Eva Clayton was elected in 1992. When was the last time North Carolina elected a Black representative to the U.S. House? Never. 54 years. 128 years. 96 years.
It's really hard about the South, y'all. Mm-hmm.
But I like that picture. I think there's if I'm not mistaken, that picture shows a representative from South Carolina, a senator from Mississippi. The correct answer is 96 years. It wasn't uncommon for African-American Republicans to be elected to Congress shortly after Reconstruction. So we had our Joseph Rainey's, our Hiram Rebels, our Blanche K. Bruce's. They were all in Congress representing for us. Glad Cheetah, 11839. Lively Ferret, 10253. And not much between second and fourth place. So this is going to be down to the wire with Groovy Tiger having a current streak of four answers. Type your answer. Part of the early American feminist movement, she advocated for reparations. Who gave the Ain't I a Woman speech? Players, type your answer.
Here's another my childhood when I was in eighth grade. Eighth grade was a formidable time for me, obviously. I memorized the speech and produced it for the class, which was really nice. It's a music.
But all of that. Don't speak Tupac in front of you. That's Tupac in front of you.
Tupac being there. Whatever. Tupac is in the picture.
Talk about your anachronisms. All right. The correct answers are Belle Bonfrey, Sojourner Truth, or Isabella Bonfrey. She changed her name after going to church because she was called by the gospel to go spread the truth. There you go. Escaped slave, took her daughter and got, and then sued a white man to recover her son. All right, Groovy Tiger. Look at there. We've got a game that's a little closer than we thought. Final question is coming up. So let's see if Groovy Tiger can overtake Glad Cheetah. Interestingly, we've got two feline names
Right. Was this set up? Are y'all in the same room together?
Three of the teams are felines, two big cats and one smaller cat. I don't know what this is over here, but yeah.
This is the time for Agent Turtle to come in.
All right, you got your money on Agent Turtle? I don't think there are 2,830 points available, but Agent Turtle might be able to get into the top three, which is really what is important as you all try to take home some of these great prizes. Let's take a break and listen. All right, people. She's the first lady of gospel music. Two times the points. With 12 Grammys, which Raleigh pastor went viral pretty much every Thanksgiving with, you name it, Pastor Carolyn Badgett, Pastor Carolyn Pettiford Riles, Pastor Shirley Caesar, Pastor Carolyn Satterfield. She used to eat at Golden Corral when I was in college. We would go there after church and she'd be over there with her family. We'd be like, oh my gosh. You know, country boy from Fayetteville. That's what we knew who she was.
I mean, that's amazing because I also listened to Shirley Caesar in Golden Corral just remix, you know? So maybe it's not the same, but it's adjacent. So shouts out to the pastor.
There you go. All right. Didn't take you all any time to figure out that we were talking about Pastor Shirley Caesar, a American and North Carolina diva and icon. Let's enjoy her serenading those people out there in Radio Land.
I don't know how the delay is, but hopefully I'm on beat with my jig. I got beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ribs, pork, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit. You name it. Beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ribs, pork, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys. Beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ribs, pork, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit. You name it. Beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, greens, potatoes, greens. Beans, 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 potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkey, beans, 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 potatoes. This gentleman dancing chicken, is having chicken, too much fun. No, he's killing it for him, I think.
Yes, he is giving you everything that you want out of a remixed, not gospel, gospel song.
Yes.
Trivia night with NCCU, the Black History Essentials. In third place, we have with 11,675 points, Lively Ferret with 12,732 points, Ruby Tiger, and 13,213 points. Our big winner for tonight, Glad Sheeta. I'm glad we got one non-cat here. Our runner-ups there in fourth are Agent Turtle and Power Bobcat. We appreciate you all joining us tonight, and before we finish,
we just got one more shout out for WNCU and a special thanks to our presenting sponsor, the Triangle-based restaurant, Your Pie Pizza. Please go check out their pasta, salads, paninis, and more. Remember, there are locations in Cary, Briar Creek, Capitol Boulevard, near the greatest host on earth that you've seen on your Thursday night. So make sure you come in, take out, pick up menus. Everything is available online at yourpie.com.
Now, don't leave yet. If you placed in the top three, take a screenshot of your screen and send it to WUNC@WUNC.org so we can make sure that you get your prize.
Yes, yes. Agent Turtle, I really just want to say, we were rooting for you.
We were rooting for you, Agent Turtle. We were.
We were rooting for you. Man. This is why I don't bet. I don't do anything of the sort, because
Kamaya, this has been so much fun.
It has.
We must do this again someday, and we hope that you all will join us the next time WUNC hosts a trivia night.